Hello, Jerry here with Dark Side Vinyl, with a little different video for you this time. Just wanted to do a quick demo with my new turntable. I had a couple questions about it when I featured it in my Instagram page, which is also Dark Side Vinyl, and when I talked about it in one of my previous videos. So I'll just be real quick here. First off, show you. I'll be using one of my latest acquisitions, which is the soundtrack to The Last of the Mohicans. And this is the re-release of that. It was the first one. People complained because they grouped all of the songs together, all the ones that were done by Trevor Jones. They grouped those together, and then they grouped the songs by Randy Edelman, which were out of order from the film. So people didn't really like that. They wanted it in the same order. So they re-released it, and I guess probably remastered it. I'm not exactly sure. I went ahead and got this version, which is the second one. And I believe this one might have been 2005. I'm not sure. Sorry. Should have checked on that before I started the video. Anyway, let me turn this around and I'll show you the turntable. So, give you a gratuitous shot of Yoda. Okay. So, one of the things that I like is that you can easily remove the dust cover and just have it like that as well, which is nice for pictures, which you probably have seen, like I said, once again on my Instagram page. But of course, most of the time I keep the cover on for the obvious reasons, but I'll leave it off for this video right now. The way my setup is, that's the cord that came with it, the cables that came with it. Unfortunately, they're going up the wall because of where my amplifier is in the receiver. I didn't want to set the turntable on top of the receiver, so I decided to go ahead and do that. And I may get some more cables and do it longer and do it differently later on, but for right now this works for me. It just doesn't look that great in pictures and in the video. But anyway, I'll show you the speed selections are under this corner right here. They're hidden, and it's a rocker switch, and go to my right is 45, and to my left is 33 and a third. Starts up the motor. And this turntable is the Pro-ject Carbon Debut Carbon Evo. It's got a carbon fiber tone arm. And this, the Evo comes with Sumiko. I'm not sure if I murdered that or not, but stylus. It's an upgraded stylus than the one that comes with the Pro-ject Debut Carbon. So obviously just lift it up, bring it over to where you want to start, and it has the counterweight, and it has a anti-skate weight as well, and then the arm just drops it down very slowly, as you see. Thank you. just when it was getting good, right? One of the neat things I wanted to show you is the ability to play 78 records, which I have a handful of 78s. I wish I had more, and I actually quit buying them when I was not able to play them. Once I really started buying albums, I would just concentrate on the 33 and a third. And I wish I had continued to look at the 78s, but I suppose I will the next time I'm in the store. So the way you play a 78 is simply remove the platter. And they give you an additional belt, which is round and larger. You see, it's a little bit different size. It's you may not be able to see it there on the video, but, and you place the other belt on the other spindle in that groove there. Well, let's do it this way. It's really not that hard. I did it right before I shot this video. And then put the platter back on. And I have this handy dandy little old record album book with 78s in it. It's not going to sound as good as the last one I just played. It's a little dirtier. But, and ironically, you put the speed on 45 in order to go 78. Let it get up to speed. There we go. Quit making noises. You can tell it's going a lot faster. And snap, crackle, pop. So you get the point. And it is cold outside today. We had snow flurries. So, that's about it. Hope you enjoyed that quick little video, and hope you don't think I'm bragging or something. I'm just glad I got this, and I had some questions about it and wanted to just kind of go over it. I unfortunately remember to do a unboxing video, which I wish I had. But anyway, this is something. So tell me what you think. I love the sound of it. Not so much on the 78, or at least not this 78, but everything else I've played, it's fantastic. Thanks. Keep on digging. Subscribe, like, comment, please. Bye.